about your plans to make me blue. With some other guy you knew before. Between the two of us guys, you know I love you more. It took me by surprise, I must say. When I found out yesterday, don't you know that I heard through the grapevine? That much longer would you be mine? Oh, I heard it through the grapevine. Oh, I'm just about to lose my mind. Honey, honey, well.
Capricorn, how you doing, guys? Okay, so this is your reading. Okay, so I'm not going to really do any more disclaimers. Okay, but please don't look too much into tarot, okay? This can mean your circumstance or not, or it may just relate in a small way, but it will only really tell you anything with a personal reading, okay? Which are normally the Skype readings, okay? They are really nothing to do with tarot. It's helping you rebuild your structural life of yourself, okay? It's more to do with that. But any of you that follow, you should know that I mention that a lot in my readings anyway, okay? Tarot cards will never really be able to predict your future because you have free will, and free will, you can jump overboard on a ship anytime you like, you know. You have that free will choice to do that. It doesn't matter. Energy can come out in a certain way, but it can change. Trust me, a ship, any kind of ship at all, can be a certain way, and it can be projected out by anybody. And a lot of people, they do suffer from narcissism, okay? And that can be pushed out into an energy. Trust me, I know that through my past karmic situations, okay? It can be pushed out into an energy of cards, but that can change month to month or week to week, or because it's a ship. You have to ask what kind of ship that you sail. I don't sail them, I build them. So anyway, let's go. And you've got 09:09 on the clock. It's 9 minutes past nine here in Britain AM. Okay, so let's have a look. Capricorn, Sun, Moon, Rising, or Venus for February. February. Okay, so you've got fighting. This can be mind games. It's a five. It's a return, and it's also a taking. Someone taking. Okay, taking something. It can be literally just a fight, or it can be mind games. This is pretty much what has gone across the board with a karmic year, okay? But this is kind of the Caped Crusader, okay? But you've got some kind of ending of the Wheel of Fortune. Now, that's either an ending or a beginning, because it's a 10. So basically, you've got 15, right? Which is, to me, which would be 5 and 1 is 6, which can be a return, okay? Like the Six of Cups. A lot of people, they kind of look at soulmate kind of energy or anything like that, okay? Life is not a fight, it's not a struggle, okay? A lot of people fall under a notion that actually love is supposed to be painful. Fuck knows why, because it's not. It's supposed to be a freeing energy. If it's controlling or restriction or anything like that, you fall under that bracket of denial, okay? Pretty much. So the Wheel of Fortune can pretty much spin out of control at any point in life that it likes. Because it's also to do with your MC, your IC, your North and South node of what it is that you've learned within the period of time that your soul is here to actually experience. If it's a karmic trunk contract, you have to see that out until you've had enough of it and decide, fuck it, bruv, I'm out, you know. If the milk turns sour, I ain't the kind of pussy to drink it. Do you know what I mean? So keep it. In fact, fuck it, Nick. You know what? Keep it. You know, that kind of energy is what I'm feeling, Capricorn. You know, it's the fight or flight. What's the point of fighting? What are you going to do if you chop someone in the throat? What's going to happen to the guy that stands behind you that you're not socially aware of? Probably stab you in the back, right? So when you're socially aware, you realise that if you fight, you lose, pretty much. Because you probably go to prison, or someone stabs you in the back. Or they get bigger and better friends to come along and do the same to you as what you've done to them. It's a stupid game of what human beings play in life. You don't participate in things, things fall apart, and then they rebuild the structure of your life, of karma, of destiny, of what's supposed to happen, because that's what it's saying. Whatever's happened, supposed to happen, whatever does happen, always happens for a reason. So let's have a look. So you've got opportunity of the Ace of Love. Someone is spying the fuck out of somebody. This is what I'm picking up, because this is also a spying card, because it can be energy of looking at people in three-parted situations. It definitely can, because the guy holds the Three of Swords. He holds the Two of Swords up in this depiction of what this is what happens as a reader, okay? I'm a channeler of messages. Whatever comes out through my gullet or my mouth is what comes out through spirit of being a conduit. That's why it's a messenger, pretty much like this in a way, because it's called communication. If we don't know how to communicate in life, what's the point? You might as well stand there with a gag around your mouth. Okay, so pretty much like this, he's holding the Two of Swords, which is the decision from the Two of Swords of being blind. Blind, stupid, realizing that two other people have actually walked away from it. I'm not calling you stupid, Capricorn, but this is just how I read. Okay, so pick it, choose it, do it, whatever. Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus, Mirror Flip, you or them, don't matter, right? Because trust me, I've had other readings where they've said, it's them, and guarantee you it's not, it's probably you, right? That's why you need self-awareness to realize, you know what? That is me. So what do I need to find? Self-respect and love and actual honesty of being able to purge out feelings and release your karma of realizing, okay, I admit this about myself. I'm a bit of a twat at times, or I'm a bit of this and a bit of that. But these are my true, honest thoughts and feelings, right? Until people can actually admit that about themselves, you stay stuck in a fighting game of maybe three people, okay? Because he holds the Three of Swords, the heartbreak, the betrayal, but he holds the Two of Swords up of decision. Okay, but these two have said, fuck it, take your two swords, we're off, we don't need a sword, we're kind of, one's a little bit further, and one's kind of like, well, I'm kind of following you, because this person here is fighting with himself, pretty much, conflicted mind thought of control, that's why it can relate to narcissism, okay? Fucking hell, this is what happens to me with readings. I am a natural born teacher, and I do apologise if that gets on people's nerves, Capricorn, but within my chart, I have Sag in the second house, Cancer in the ninth, and Aquarius, and I don't want to go into my chart, but they're all teaching. Fourth house, I think it is Aquarius, and I've got shitloads of stuff going on as a Piscean with Lilith and with Chiron. Jesus Christ, I am seeing some stuff, pretty much, because I have Aquarius, there you go. Okay, so, you've got the, let's have a look. So, the Ace of Cups is love, right? It's love, but it's eternal love. It's felt because of God, right? Pretty much, I don't want to do too much into that. But that's kind of like religion, a newborn self, a new religion, maybe. One dream, one goal. One pride, one joy, yeah, something like that. One golden glance of what could be. So it's destiny. What could be is destiny, right? So it's opportunity. Opportunity. So that could be your, it's a kind of magic. It's a kind of magic. So that is destiny of karma to me, which is like Aquarian. Okay, so you could be interested in Aquarius, or they are you. Okay, but this is Adam and Eve and Lilith. This is like detoxing. That's what I'm saying. You detoxify yourself of like drugs or alcohol or anything like that, and you have the light of day. So wish fulfillment. Your wish fulfillment comes true. Okay, true. But if it's someone that does this to you, or you're thinking, well, it's them doing that, the other person that they're involved with, they've got fucking blue hair and they look like a Muppet. Or something like that, okay? You can't project blame at someone else that's with someone else, because then you're still in the fighting game, aren't you? You know, you can't say, well, the person that he's with or she's with is fucking stupid. Well, you know, ask yourself the questions. That's what happens with ascension. If you blame someone else for being someone else, but then they come back to you and tell you that they love you, then what are they doing? Playing mind games, right? So you learn, hopefully. So, pretty much, because you can get pulled back into this cycle. This is a cycle. You can get pulled back into it because it's a five. That's a 10. Six, reflection, back of, okay? You reflect back on a six, okay? Pretty much, well, to me, I don't know other readers, but that's just me. You reflect back on a six, so you can go backwards in ascension. You can. And you can fall under that bracket of denial of love that it can't be felt until you feel it within yourself to be independent from anything. Independent and karmic free, your freedom of speech and your freedom of thought keeps you clear-minded and clear of anything. Okay, so it brings in abundance of law of attraction. Law of attraction. I'm going to be doing different modules over on Vimeo, hopefully as soon as I get my accountant sorted out and everything like that. Hopefully we'll go over to do different things that I've got planned. But anyway, you could be in love with either an Aquarius or a King of Swords, King of Wands. Okay, But a Page of Swords can be Gemini, Libra, Aquarius, okay, is looking probably at a water sign or looking at extending an offer. Extending an offer, okay? But you see, this is not equality. This is taking. This is fuck it, Nick. You know what? I'll keep it, bruv. Because this is below this. Someone is giving more to one than the other. This can be energy, okay? But if you're in a ship, you have to know if you're in a ship. If so, you're right. Don't get confused, okay? Because I will do what energy can feel like as well, spiritually wise. But you really basically have to be in a ship in order to know someone's cheating on you or not. If you're not actually in a ship, then whatever people do behind your back or whatever, then that's down to them, okay? But you've got to be in a ship to know that you're actually in a ship with two other people, okay? If you're in it to win it, what are you fighting for? Freedom? Because that is kind of like telling me that that's somebody giving more to one than the other, okay? That can be family, marriages. I'm kind of picking up care home for some reason. Like someone's on the street, homeless, I'm picking up. Could have Aquarius in their chart. That's only for a select few, obviously. But the King of Wands, now the King of Wands, okay, can be eccentric. He can be leadership material, but can be very sometimes aloof, okay? Like the impingement that I pick up through this card, right? He's not really sitting upright. He's kind of like slouching a bit. Kind of like, well, you know, fuck it, you know. Where's my queen gone? Is she over there? Because he's looking over there, right? And his queen happens to be a Aquarius. Sun, Moon, Rising, or Venus, okay? This can be Aries, Leo, Sagittarius, Sun, Moon, Rising, or Venus, or even Jupiter, okay? Or just being socially aware. But there seems to be some kind of love here because it's wish fulfillment. Let's have a look. Capricorn, Sun, Moon, Rising, or Venus. See, that's what I'm on about, independence. And you've got the Seven of Swords turning up. A frenemy. You've got to be careful of frenemies, definitely with Lilith and Chiron and all that happening. Frenemies. Right, okay, so it's took healing. Someone is healing from communication, but... You know, the pages are the progression of child, of soul growth, evolution. So when I call people childish, don't mean to say that you're a kid. I pretty much mean that what is the point in life if people can't speak or talk? Don't speak. I know just what you're saying. You know, we are psychic in life, Capricorn, but people do actually need speech, you know. If that's a spying game, someone's stalking the fuck out somebody, because that is a stalking card too, you know. And your overall energy is, could be three-party collaboration. And you've got Gemini. A decision. I'm not going to go into those because I keep doing that. Okay, but something to do with Gemini, Sun, Moon, Rising, or Venus, or Jupiter. Okay. So let's have a quick gander. So you've got the Three of Pentacles as the overall energy of collaborating, maybe, working together as a team. Pink Floyd, Three Pigs, is it? Have a cigar. Come on in here, boy, have a cigar, you're gonna go far. You're gonna fly high, you're gonna make it if you try. No, I'm gonna love you. Yeah, so... Someone could be impressed with someone is what I'm picking up. They're impressed. Because the King of Wands is like an impression to me. Makes an imprint on your life in a certain way. This doesn't have to be a fire sign. It can just be someone that holds that elemental thought of or energy of forward leadership and motivation, but also relaxed, a bit like this, right? A bit like, all right, how you getting on? You know, relaxed, but leadership also knows, fuck it, you're out, bruv. You know, can be a bit eccentric and a bit stupid sometimes. But let's have a look. So let's have a look at the Five of Swords. What's the Five of Swords here for? Five of Swords. Five of Swords. Five of Swords. I didn't really take them. Something to do with Virgo. And, well, I mean, that's just pointless. That's someone, because this can be depression, right? Depression from fucking not knowing your head from your arsehole, pretty much, right? And then this is kind of like, well, I'm just not going to do anything about it then. I'm just going to pretty much just sort of focus on the past, really. I'm not going to accept offers, and I'm not really going to move anywhere, because the Hermit can talk about non-moving, which is kind of depression, and it can also mean stubbornness also. Not all Virgos are stubborn, but they are that kind of quality of. They're also the opposite sign to Pisces, which can also be a Pisces also, okay? Which is stuck in a cycle. Stuck in a cycle of things just really not going anywhere. Just thought, feeling, well, you're very grounded. Well, you're very grounded too. So what are we doing about it? Going around in circles like a daisy chain. One step, two step, sorry. One step. One step ahead of what? The competition. One step ahead of the competition. Fuck knows why I picked that up. One step ahead of the competition. Someone's caught in some kind of three-party triangle, mush, I'm telling you. Somebody's caught in something, in a trap. Caught in a trap, I won't hold back, because I love you too much, baby. Why can't you see what you're doing to me? Sorry, I'm just having a bit of fun, Capricorn. I hope this is not happening to you. Because I love you too much, baby. What, I mean, to keep things stuck in the game? What's life about? Someone tell me that. So, what is life about? Is it a game? Well, it must be if you're watching tarot cards, because you can't be in a happy situation. So where do you get out of it? Fight somebody? Or let them go? Of course. You let them go, right? Because if it ain't meant to be, it ain't meant to be. Because whatever will be. Destiny. So let's have a look. The Wheel of Fortune. Fighting. Conflict across the internet. That's what I'm picking up. Conflict across the internet. Please excuse me, Capricorn. I don't want this to go on, but I just need to make a note. Right, so, sorry. Conflict across the internet is what I'm picking up. This is fighting across texts, emails, childish communication. Do not go to your, Rahu, which is spying and manipulating and texts and emails, because that's spying, that's manipulating, that's trying to judge someone. This is like judging and spying on somebody and manipulating, twisting. It's called being an adult. It's called having adult conversations. You can't spy on people. You've got to let them go, you know, because you can't blame other people for being other people. If someone's lost, they're lost in the dark. You know, it's simple as that. You know, you can't, you're not, because it just seems stuck. It's like it, I keep picking up that somebody is like spying on the internet. That means that you're interested more in someone else, and then you have to ask yourself, well, why are you interested more in someone else than yourself? So obviously it's karma, right? So it's very painful, and I do understand that because I've been through it. Okay, so I do understand that. But if this is literally going through people's fucking emails and literally hacking, because this is like hacking, hacking away, I'm picking up, like hacking away. Someone's hacking someone's shit, bruv. Phones, someone's hacking someone's phone. Phone jacker. Someone's hacking someone's email. That might not come out with any other reader, but that's what I'm picking up, okay? If it relates to you, it does. If it don't freak the fuck out if you don't know. If you don't know that, it doesn't relate to you. So don't come up with any kind of fucking saga in your mind to start worrying that that might be happening. You would hopefully know that if you know your partner, right? Let's have a look at the Page of Swords. Page of Swords. Page of Swords. Page of Swords. It could be an Aquarius that's involved in that, you know? So that's Leo, maybe. Possible Leo, with air in their chart, maybe. Gemini, Libra, Aquarius, maybe Leo, possible. It doesn't really matter with the Sun, because the Sun's the best card in the deck, basically. It's growth, so it's growth of wisdom, okay? It's clarified that. So someone is growing through learning that fighting is not the fucking way that you go about life. It's kind of like, if you fight, right, if you're fighting to get back into a ship, then you need a fucking grapple hook in order to jet ski behind it to try and get in it. So what you have to ask yourself is, how the fucking long did that decide to actually jump overboard? Because it took me a long time to jump overboard, because I was going to fucking drown in my emotions, right? I was going to drown in my emotions and feelings of love. Well, what is love? Do you think it's a fight? Do you think it's a battle? It isn't. It's freeing. It's energy. It comes from the soul. That's why I'm a soul speaker. I speak from the soul, not from the ego. And I only do it when my energy is raised and I come back in order to do people's readings. That's why they relate in a different way. That's why I have great quality of being feminine and masculine. Both. You better believe it. I don't sink ships, I build them. I rebuild the inner structure of yourself to know what love really is. If you're in denial, you're in denial and you need to do it again. Okay? That's why the Skype calling is more beneficial to your circumstance, where I can truly help you. Cards will just relate and help the reader see further. Further. Okay? Because it's energy felt, spoken, channeled. Okay? but that's waiting, something to do with family. There's your ships, there's three ships. I am sailing, someone's wanting to travel to see maybe their parent, their childhood. They could be, so this is another spin of what I'm picking up, someone is communicating maybe across the internet with something to do with their family of when they were a child, and they are wanting to actually, they're waiting for news to find out whether they can actually go and see them or not. That's another story, that's not everybody. And it's causing conflict. Could have something to do with an Aquarius that has got Leo in their chart. Ascendant Leo. Leo rising, maybe. Don't know. That's obviously just a few. But let's have a look. Yeah, there's something to do with someone wanting to go and see their family member that they probably haven't seen for a very long time, and they're still waiting on a reply, or someone is waiting on a reply with love, and they're probably thinking, for fuck's sake, will you grow up? Sorry, that's a message to someone. For fuck's sake, will you grow up and be independent? Will you fucking grow up and be independent? Right? It's not to everybody. I don't know where that was coming. That's the Seven of Swords. So there you go. That's a frenemy. Someone's got a frenemy somewhere. I was looking at the Star. The Star. Please clarify the Star, please. What's the Star here for? Okay. So that's like a return of energy. That's the Knight of Wands. So someone's very passionate and driven about an Aquarius. Yeah. Someone's stable. Someone's trying to stable their emotions. Let's have a look more at the Knight of Wands. Knight of Wands. What's the Knight of Wands here for? The Knight of Wands. Someone's passionate about an Aquarius, Sun, Moon, Rising, or Venus, but is having inner conflict about spying or something, or something to do with the internet or hacking of what I said. Knight of Wands. Knight of Wands. Because that can also be like a narcissism card, also the Knight of Wands. It doesn't have to be. But that's the leapfrog effect. Leapfrog effect. 1 minute I'm in, next minute I'm out. So communication is in, then you fight, then it's out. Communication comes in, you fight, you're out. And then someone, Gemini, Libra, Aquarius, has now pretty much said, fuck it. I'm had enough of people fucking just taking. I need the fucking truth. That's what I'm picking up. Because the King of Wands, which is Leo, Aries, Sagittarius, is also looking at an Aquarius. So I'm picking up Leo more, really. Leo than I am Aries. Leo is somewhere within Leo's chart, okay? Spying. So here we go. Somewhere like Leo, okay, is spying at an Aquarius, Sun, Moon, Rising, or Venus. And the feeling is like passion, feeling like an underlying feeling, underlying, because that can be like that warm nurturing that people give off as, I mean, I have Aquarius in Venus and a lot of places in my chart, right? You know, when you're a healer, you know, when you feel real good, okay, and then real bad, and it's like someone's just stole your warmth, they've just stole your light, okay, it comes in and they try to gain that substance from your light. And then that can make you feel like you're detoxing when you're empathic and that, because you feel like someone's just stole something. You do, trust me, you do. But it can be causing inner conflict or something, and someone's now, you know what, fuck it. I am fucking sick to death of this bullshit, you know. Which this energy is going to be floating around. It's definitely with me, because I've got a fucking lot of Mars going on in my chart at the moment, my natal chart. A lot of Mars action. My chart is going to be fucking off the chart. My chart is off the chart at the moment. I am experiencing some very weird stuff, but you don't want to hear about me, Capricorn, but I am, trust me. Let's have a look at the King of Wands, because you've got the Queen of Swords and the King of Wands. King of Wands. Something to do with Taurus or commitment. Six of Cups, so karma, that's karmic law, karmic contract, marriages, law-abiding citizens, law, legal documents, okay, what I said about reflection of past, here again, there's the Six of Cups, it's a six, so it's a runaround, it's again, someone's running around, you've got a chaser and a runner, that's probably why the seven picked up, that's the running card to me, the chaser and the runner. Someone's running from responsibility, someone returns and they run away. Fly away, Peter, fly away, Paul, come back, Peter, come back, Paul. Okay, so this could be somebody wants to get married or is getting married. But someone's... See, the sixes talk about marriages and children, having children together is what I'm picking up. Two of Cups. I don't know why, but I'm picking up two soulmates. Two soulmates. It's possible, trust me, because we have karmic soulmates, right? Karmic soulmates is someone from the long past, okay? This means past. Can mean the short past, but basically it can mean the long past, because you've also got like Taurus, which is... fixed for a long time, right? Basically meaning. So this can mean the long past keeps revisiting and playing out the same fucking cycle because it's the same. Okay, so it means karma. Okay, but then you've got that coupled and clarified with the two, which is new. So someone's having inner conflict and arguing with two different soulmates. Two different soulmates. And this can have anyone in their chart, anywhere in the chart. One of the people that is in love, it can be, because this is kind of a Pisces I'm picking up, really. But it can be a mixture of Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces, and they've got Taurus, Leo, I'm thinking in their chart, maybe Cancer or Pisces. Someone that has like a Leo of what I was saying about rising, maybe. Taurus somewhere within Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus or Jupiter. But I have this in my seventh house. This to me relates to my seventh house, which is descendant, which is Taurus. Okay, that's why it's very kind of like I have a traditional way of doing things. That's why I'm so structured sometimes in my way of teaching. Okay, because it's loyal. It's loyalty. Okay, loyalty, a bit like Virgo. I don't know, I'm picking up on different, like Virgo, loyalty. See, Taurus is like the traditional way, can be, if you get healthy Taurus, okay? Virgo. But there's something going on weird here with the, but, water signs, fire, water, Taurus, in their chart, someone's chart. And Leo again, spying, maybe. Let's have a quick look. My dog is just about to go ballistic again. Let's have a quick look at the Three of Pentacles. The Three of Pentacles. What is the Three of Pentacles here for? Three of Pentacles. Three of Pentacles. Seven of Cups. There you go. Options. Making. Right. So let's bring it round, Capricorn. Right? Come here a minute. Right. So someone, okay, is going to learn a valuable lesson through better choices in life because it's causing a lot of fucking heartache to somebody. Okay, a lot of heartache. You must know if you suffer from a heartache because your vibration will be low. Okay, if you don't admit that, then you put a mask on so you don't learn anything. Okay, so someone is collaborating with someone else. They're communicating with someone else and someone else. Okay. And that they're trying to make choices because one of the choices comes back around. What goes around comes around. This is also my life path number, okay? Why I can absorb dark energy from people because I guide and help them, okay? So this is what I was saying about the underlining energy. You absorb a lot of that and you have to clear it because this is me, always dressed in black, okay? The man in black, okay? But making wise choices in life, okay? Which one's pink? Because that seems pink, but that seems like heartache. So, bring it around, the lesson that is being taught is independency. Declaration of independence. War. Someone's drew a line across the sand. Okay? Pretty much. And this is what it needs to teach people, is being independent. Free, karmic free, karmic free, okay? Pretty much exactly how I feel just lately is freedom, freedom, freedom. But that's pretty much what I'm kind of picking up as a lesson, because that can be clarified by that, they're all upside down, okay? So someone is trying, someone out of it has broke free of this illusion and heartache and is now found independence. Communication could have been cutting. Communication can be cutting or has been, or this is just information. They're using their intuition, can be Pisces, and the Empress, which is like the Empress. She comes back when she knows that guidance is needed to use the feminine approach as well as the masculine. She's great at being a masculine and a feminine, the High Priestess. She takes time in order to gather her thoughts. She's very relaxed, grounded. Once she gathers her thoughts, she looks down at the kingdom and says, right, I'm coming down. Enough is enough. I have great intuition and I'm going to sort this fucking mess right out. Okay? Whatever that is that the Empress takes on as a quality to do. Okay? Because she's extremely intuitive. Like Pisces. Okay? And then you've got the Pisces card. Pisces. So, all that can mean Cancer, Scorpio. Okay? But that to me is Pisces card. Okay? Because they're kind of like, all right, let's have a look in my cup. In the past. Okay? Leads you into illusion. You realise, where the fuck am I? Is it real? Is my feelings real? That's why I teach people about using your intuition, because it's only told by the amount of pain you experience in time, because that's why it's divine time. Divine time. Okay, so that's your reading, Capricorn. I hope you enjoyed the show. Okay, but that was some kind of show. If you would like a Skype call in, okay, I do have a few, I think, booked up for the weekend. Okay, I'm waiting to reply for a few, but I think there is a few. Okay, but if you would like a Skype call reading, just send me an email, or the information is on my business page, which is Becoming the Change on Facebook. Okay, or you can follow any of the links, and the song to your video will be in the description also. Okay, all right, guys, peace, and I'll hopefully see you soon for your weeklies and bi-weeklies and whatever I come up with of an idea that I come up with. Okay, all right, guys, peace, cheers, boo.